Hi guys, this is Sushant, Kochar, and today we are going to talk about can you lose weight without following a structured diet plan. I talked about what a structured diet plan is in my previous video, and so I'll not discuss what a structured diet plan is, but basically a structured diet plan is where you have planned the diet plan, when you have given thoughts to what should be in the diet plan, what shouldn't be, what would be helpful to the good for the health, and what would be bad for the health, what is needed to be kept in the diet and what isn't needed to be kept in the diet. So the answer is, without following a structured diet plan, yes, you can lose weight. But if you try to lose weight with your estimation, okay, I'll increase the exercise and I'll decrease the food, and that is how we lose weight. Yes, if you're in calorie deficit, you'll lose weight, but there are a lot of chances that you're going to be going in the wrong direction. If by chance you end up doing what you wanted to, you end up doing good for your body, then I would say that consider it as luck, not your smartness. I would say that. So basically the answer is that if by chance your without so thought of diet plan worked for you in the right way, then it is mostly because of luck, according to me. Otherwise, if you do not have a structured diet plan, you are most likely to go in the wrong direction. So basically that means you should have a structured diet plan. Now, if you do not have a structured diet plan, you would not know if you are going in the right direction or not, if you are going towards your goal or not. So for example, if you just abruptly started eating whatever and you thought that, oh, it would work, just keep exercising and keep eating whatever, you would not know if you are in a calorie surplus or a calorie deficit. So maybe if you want to lose weight, you would not know if you are in a calorie deficit. If you want to gain weight, you would not know if you are in a calorie surplus. If today you ate a little bit more, you would be on a calorie surplus today. If tomorrow you ate a little less, you would be in a calorie deficit tomorrow. Overall, after a month, you see that your weight is still the same, and you would think that, oh, I have been following the diet for a month and still I haven't lost weight or gained weight. So basically, it is hard to know without calculating what your maintenance calories are based on what exercises you are doing and what your BMR is, and then calculating the amount of food that you are going to eat, and seeing how much difference between the maintenance calories and food is, how you will gain weight, how you will lose weight. So you have to do all those calculations. If you haven't done those calculations, then you wouldn't know if you are going in the right direction or not. If you are in a surplus every day, or if you are in a deficit every day, or if you are maintaining every day, you wouldn't know. Secondly, let's say if you eat less to assure a deficit or a surplus, you still might experience a muscle loss. So muscle loss or fat gain. So let's say if you wanted to get weight, then you abruptly started eating a lot of food and started exercising, eating a lot of food, most probably you will gain weight because you're eating a lot of food more than your hunger. But gaining weight too quickly can lead to a lot of fat gain, and when you're gaining weight, you want to minimize fat gain and maximize muscle gain. So how would you know if you're gaining weight the right way? Gaining weight or losing weight is not the big deal. Gaining weight while gaining maximum muscle and minimum fat, and losing weight while retaining maximum muscle and losing maximum fat is the right way. So you want to be in the right direction, so you would not know when you abruptly create a surplus. And when you create the deficit, so I'll talk about deficit over here. So if you eat less, okay, you try to assure that you're in a deficit. So what you did was you abruptly started eating half of what you were eating and started doing 1.5 hours of exercise instead of 1 hour. That is what a lot of people do. Or what you did was you started eating 2/3 of what you were eating and you doubled the time of your workout. Okay, you did so, but still you can lose muscle. How? Because you do not know. If you made sure that you are burning more energy, burning more calories than you are eating, but you don't know if your calorie deficit is too big. If you don't know what calorie deficit or calorie surplus is, please check in my previous videos. But you wouldn't know if your calorie deficit is too big. If you're eating too lesser than your maintenance calories, if you eat too less, you can experience muscle loss. So you wouldn't know if you're losing muscle or not. Even if when you feel that your strength goes down, you would come to know, but by that time you have already lost some muscle. So you wouldn't know if you're eating too less or if you're eating the right amount. Okay, now someone can tell me, okay, I'll assure that I'm in a calorie surplus or a calorie deficit. I'll see the videos that you have made on maintenance calories and I'll calculate my maintenance calories and I'll see the amount of calories in my food. I'll see your video on Indian food composition table and I'll find the calorie amount in my food. And I'll see how much gap is there between maintenance calories and the amount of food I'm eating and how much weight I'll lose with this and how much weight I'll gain. Okay, you have done all that calculation and estimation. Okay, but still you can lose muscle. How? Because when you have decided that you are going to be eating this much food and this is enough food to eat, but you haven't made the right choices of food. You might be eating only paneer for your majority of the calories, thinking that it will give me a lot of protein and I'll save myself from muscle loss. But at the same time, you have left yourself behind for vitamins and minerals. How would you fulfill your requirements for vitamins and minerals? You should be giving antioxidants to your body for your long-term health, and you should also look at other nutrients in your diet plan. So you do not need to just be looking at the calories. You need to look at if you're giving the right amounts of all the nutrients in your diet. So basically, this is what I wanted to tell you, that if you all of a sudden think, okay, I'll exercise and I'll reduce the diet, I'll eat a bit lesser and I'll start losing weight, then you might harm your body. So it is better to form a structured diet plan. You can still lose weight without a structured diet plan, I told you in the start, but the chances are that you are likely going to be harming your body. So it is better to make a structured diet plan where you make sure that you're eating enough food, you're not craving for food every day, you're feeling that okay, I'm losing weight and I'm kind of eating enough food for the day and meeting the nutrition requirements for your body at the same time. Now most people who try to do this on their own without forming any diet plan and throw themselves in, okay, I'll do more exercise, eat less, the majority of the times they end up damaging their metabolism in this sort of smartness. They experience muscle loss, and when you lose muscle, your metabolism goes down and you end up damaging your metabolism. So basically, try to follow a structured diet plan. Now I have talked about this in my previous video on what is a structured diet plan. Again, I'll give a brief. Yes, I give paid training. I'm a certified nutritionist. If you want paid training from me, you can message me on Instagram. I do give paid training because I need to earn some money from my profession to meet my expenses. So a lot of people message me on Instagram for diet plans, but then they stop messaging me when I tell them that I give paid training. So yes, I do need some money for my expenses from my profession, and I am making the videos on this YouTube channel in a way that you can learn to create your own diet plan, but it will take time. Still, if you still learn to make your own diet plan, it might be necessary for you to have an experienced person's eyes on you to see if you're going in the right direction or not. And I have myself done weight loss and weight gain about 3 times by now, and I will perhaps someday make a video on my own transformation story and post it on YouTube. But till then, if you like the video, please like, comment and subscribe. I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.